Okay, guys, I picked up this Weber barbecue. It's the Smoky Joe, which is 58444. I bought it at Amazon. It was like $50. I seen it there at Lowe's last fall when I was there. And I thought, well, that's a nice little barbecue. That's pretty freaking hot already. And then I got the 7447 rapid fire chimney starter. So you put your charcoal inside, which I'm using Royal Oak hardwood lump charcoal. You put that on the inside there and then just light it. And literally it's been like 5 minutes and I'm thinking I'm ready to dump that charcoal on the barbecue and it should be ready to go. It's hard to tell though whether it is or isn't. I'm gonna let it go until I see flames coming out the top, but yeah, first time cooking with charcoal back here. Should be pretty interesting. So I'm gonna do a couple burgers, nothing major. But still, it's a decent sized barbecue. 14 inches across, it says. I think it's bigger than that, personally, but yeah, fuck, it's not even 14, it's 13 and a half, so I don't understand why they advertise it as a 14 inch grill. So another company that lies. Anyways, they said that this chimney starter thingy would actually work within 5 minutes, so I'm hoping it's correct. Looks like it's doing the job. I also got these bellows. I didn't buy them on Amazon. I got them from AliExpress for a lot cheaper. Exactly the same thing as what Amazon sells. And I'm just going to put some air in here. You'll be able to hear it. Some nice embers flying out. Anyways, I got that mainly for the wood-fired barbecue, but something's shooting out there. Anyways, I think it's lit, so I'm gonna just go ahead and dump the charcoal out. If it isn't lit, well, we'll soon find out. But no, it's lit. Look at that, and it worked really good. Like literally 10 minutes, and this thing here got my charcoal fire going. So I'm just going to go ahead and put the other grill on here. I don't know if you can see that, but the coals are nice and hot. Definitely nice and hot. So, and you know, I'm not going to cook on this right away because I want to burn off any factory sludges on there. They don't recommend that you do that, but I think it's a good idea. Now, the one thing I noticed about this barbecue is there's no handles on the outside to lift it in any way, shape, or form, so I gotta figure that one out. And then, you know, there's a couple little temperature dials that you can play with here. I need to figure out which one to open, which one to close. But, so that rapid fire chimney thing started my charcoal very, very quickly. So that works well. Anyway, they're gonna have to keep this thing, all this English, French, German, you know, Spanish, whatever. Eventually I'll read the instructions. So anyways, I'm gonna let this thing burn off here, and then I'm gonna just slowly add a couple more lumps of charcoal, and then I'm gonna cook my dinner on it. Hopefully it's not too hot that it's gonna break this table. But so far so good, looks pretty good to me. It's an actual Weber. Now, I've seen these at Lowe's. They were the same price, $50 last fall. I never did make it back up there again to get one. My plan was to go a week or so ago, but I never did. So, you know, this will be the stove that I can, or a barbecue that I can take with me camping. Not that I'm going to cook a whole huge amount of stuff on it, but Be great for cooking burgers and stuff. We'll just see anyways. If it's no good, I'm just gonna sell it. Just advertise it as broken in, tested, whatever. But yeah, there's quite a bit of heat coming off of this, and that's what they say about charcoal. It gets very hot and stays very hot. See, now that's too hot to touch with your hand, so I'm thinking, you know, you need something to be able to, you know, manipulate this stuff while it's cooking. But, and I think it says the temperature goes to 500 degrees inside here. I think it goes to 500 and stays there. I don't think you can vary it too much unless you use the direct indirect method of cooking. I almost bought the little trays to do indirect, but they said they would only fit in a 22-inch barbecue. Well, this ain't 22. It's not even 14. It's 13 and a half. You'd wonder why. They must measure across the outside of this lip or something. But I could have swore I read somewhere the grilling surface is 14 inches in diameter. A lie. But anyways, they say this handle doesn't get hot. And that's smoking pretty good. That's smoking hot inside there. I can feel the heat coming out here. So, I mean, it'd be a lot like the wood fired oven. Which, once you get your coals down to, you know, a reasonable amount and no flame, you get hot heat like this. So, now it's burning off any, you know, factory scent or paint or whatever. I should get out the temperature gun and just check it on the outside and see what it actually is. But I think if I open these all the way, that would be the full temperature. I should really do that the first time. That is too hot to touch with your hand. So yeah, anyways, thought I would try it out. And this chimney thing, this rapid fire starting chimney or whatever, that worked good. It definitely does as advertised. I think I got this for like $16 off of Amazon. I don't necessarily think it's worth that much money because it's, you know, basically 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces of metal fabricated together. But anyways, it works. So it ends up, you know, I don't want to buy one of those electric fire starters, mainly because I don't have electricity out here that's easily accessible. So the experience of cooking here in the backyard or in the middle of the woods somewhere would not be the same because I wouldn't have the electricity to start the barbecue. So this, I figured, is just the best way to do it. Anyways, so no sense you waiting hours for me to cook the hamburgers. I'm sure you've seen a hamburger before, but that's my goal. Burn this down and then light her up again and cook some burgers on it. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Have a great night.